That interest in Caitlin Clark is still real, and it's spectacular. The numbers are in from the debut of Clark and the Indiana Fever, the first WNBA game for Caitlin that was aired on ESPN2. And here's the thing. It outrated what was on ESPN proper, which was an NHL playoff game. Now, hockey is not considered, you know, a top sport in this country. It used to be the core four, people would say. But hockey is distantly behind, obviously, football, basketball, baseball. And I could even argue soccer now, not the MLS, but soccer as a whole. Nevertheless, it is a mainstay sport in America, and it was a playoff game. Not to mention, it had the advantage of being on ESPN versus ESPN2, which still matters. You know, you don't think about it that way in today's streaming era, but it does still matter considering the fact that, you know, some packages might not have ESPN2. Some people might not know where ESPN2 is, those sorts of things. Now, of course, this was Clark's WNBA debut, so there's that natural curiosity factor. You have to see how long this lasts. But we've seen this explosion. You know, we've seen it. I just did a video earlier today on Angel Reese and the interest in her game, the Mystics, you know, going to a bigger venue. You've seen more on social media, like Kelsey Plum was all over social media with the fit that she wore to the game. And obviously, Caitlin Clark has been the catalyst for this, and people have followed this story for a minute now. And there was a lot of reaction to it, which I'll discuss at length on the show. But bottom line is, people care. People care. People are interested. They're tuning in. You know, and it didn't really eat into the NBA playoff game that came later on TNT. But again, that was on TNT. I would have been interested to see even an apples-to-apples comparison between those two on the same stations. But nonetheless, that's a big number for the WNBA. And more people are talking. I mean, it's the biggest number ever for the WNBA, I believe. And more people are talking about it today than ever before. And I don't know if that even counts the streaming. I believe it was the first sporting event ever on Disney Plus. So in a sense, Caitlin's a Disney princess. Now, I don't want to make it that doesn't give her enough sporting power, right? That's not the imagery that you think. She's a hooper, not a princess. What's a word for the court? I don't know. I'm sorry. I got off on a tangent there. Nevertheless, clearly people wanted to see her. Clearly, people are going to be following the WNBA and the Fever, especially the Fever, as a result of this and how Caitlin Clark bounces back. It's a shame that she picked up those two fouls early. That probably took her a little bit out of her rhythm. But again, she did seem to sort of find it a little bit later. And part of that journey will be interesting to see, right? To see how she overcomes the obstacles. But because it ain't going to be easy. It ain't going to be easy. But people are going to be down to watch.